There are several new studies out on the rare side effects of the COVID vaccines that could use some context.
Chris Horapsky talks to the experts and sees how these studies could help some Minnesotans in their search for answers.
That was great.
Craig Norcus has been shooting stories at Care 11 for 22 years.
That'll make the prep show tonight.
But in November of 2022, he became ill with something he still cannot fully explain.
I was in pain. I was lost, looking for answers, and no one had any.
2 days after receiving an mRNA COVID vaccine, Craig says he started suffering head and body aches, severe exhaustion, confusion, along with cool and hot tingling in his fingers and legs.
I felt like I was dying.
Blood tests revealed his immune system was under attack, but five separate specialty doctors could not explain the source of his symptoms. In April last year, an osteopathic doctor diagnosed him with immunosuppression and small fiber neuropathy. The doctor believed was triggered by a COVID vaccine.
At first, did you even think it was the vaccine?
No, I never thought that at all.
Craig's diagnosis remains controversial in science and politics, and there are others with claims just like Craig's. At the same time, there is no study to date that's been able to prove these mRNA vaccines can cause these neurological issues.
This study from the National Academy of Sciences came out last week. After reviewing all available research, it found only one adverse event with a proven link to the Pfizer and Moderna shots. That is myocarditis, or inflammation of the heart, and it is rare. The researchers determined there's just not enough evidence to accept or deny a link to any other neurological issues studied.
Basically, if you are looking at side effects of the various COVID vaccines, it's exactly what we expected it would be at about the rate we thought it would be.
Dr. Tim Shacker, infectious disease expert at the University of Minnesota Medical School, says all vaccines come with inherent risk of rare side effects. But he says the risks after COVID are far worse. This study out of New York University found the risk of neurological problems after a COVID infection to be 617 times higher than after a COVID vaccine. Despite all this vaccine safety data and well-defined threat of COVID, Pew Research found only 28% of U.S. adults are up to date on their COVID shots.
I think I hear a lot from people who say, well, I had COVID, I didn't go to the hospital, I was fine. Why take the risk of being vaccinated when there's risks associated with it?
Well, I mean, you can make that argument with measles, you can make that argument with flu, you can make that argument with any vaccine there is. And then the other issue is just public health. We have a lot of people who will die of COVID. In this country, it was 1 million people. Had we had the vaccine sooner or a better uptake of it, that number would have been significantly smaller.
But as I said earlier, there are still questions no study has been able to answer. There have been 13 billion COVID vaccines given around the world, but only a few studies citing people with neurological issues after the shots. This one out of Germany identifies 191 people that developed a combination of chronic neurological symptoms shortly after vaccination. None had prior COVID infections, nor a history of these symptoms, just like Craig.
And we can't turn our backs on them.
Dr. Harlan Krumholtz, a cardiologist at the Yale School of Medicine, is trying to find some answers.
The polarization of this issue, the politics that surround it, I think are an impediment to people coming in and doing this kind of research.
He co-created what's called the LISTEN study, identifying 241 people reporting an overlap of symptoms like excessive fatigue, numbness, brain fog, and neuropathy following mRNA vaccination. About one-third of the participants say they did have COVID at least once.
And there are really very few options for them. We don't know very much about how to help them. We don't know how to even be clearly diagnose them.
I wasn't concerned.
People like Ashley Moe and Susanna Newell, both from the Twin Cities, both participants in that Yale study.
That first day, I thought, oh, this is just normal. Everybody has this sort of reaction.
Ashley says heart palpitations led to some 30 neurological symptoms days after her third shot. That persisted throughout her pregnancy and continues today. For Susanna.
This took me down within less than 2 days.
Her doctors diagnosed more than a dozen disorders after her second COVID shot. The issues lasting more than 2 years now.
I ended up in the hospital at the Mayo, and I think they thought I had COVID long haul, but I kept saying I've never had COVID.
Even today, people like Craig can't prove the source of their suffering. but they find some comfort together, hoping for relief as the science moves forward.
There's no vaccine in history that has been in a position where it hasn't caused some harm. I mean, it's about net benefit. Look, millions of lives were saved with these vaccines. There's no question that it was a huge net benefit. And it's incumbent upon us to listen carefully and pay attention to what they're experiencing and to work hard to try to help them.
Chris Harapsky, CARE 11 News.
Well, Chris cited a lot of studies in that report. If you'd like to read them for yourself, they are all linked with this story on our website, care11.com.
All right.